Hi viewers, welcome to a not rambling video, but a hanging out video with your boy, Gildem, featuring
me, Chasisrad, here again.
Yeah, cause he's my co-commentator, especially when I'm drunk, which I am, cause we were just filming something for the channel, which is a surprise. I don't want to say anything, Chas, keep it a secret.
I'll keep it a secret, but okay. I mean, you can use your guessing games to maybe figure it out, but it's gonna be good. You're gonna like it.
Yeah, it's a little different, but I will give you this. It's Mega Man. It's Mega Man.
See, I was gonna try to keep the illusion, but yeah it's Mega Man.
It's
Mega Man. You know,
I won't
coming.
Tell you which one, just in case. Like, I've moved on to various ones. So no timestamp, but it is Mega Man. Unless we've already done Mega Man 10, which I guess that ruins the illusion of it, but
we should try to unlock Jude.
Judas.
I don't even know how to do that.
You know what? Fine. I'll do that.
I don't know how.
I don't remember. I guess it's not. Oh, you know what I gotta do? I gotta do Mom. Anyways. So it's a hangout video. I'm playing Binding of Isaac, because normally I would do Pikmin, because that's what I've been doing in my rambling videos. But, you know, I tried doing a rambling video, it didn't work out so well. Also, my week hasn't been all that exciting, so I figured, Chas, you want to hang out with me and, like, record a video?
Yeah, just to have cool down.
Yeah. Because, you know, that has to happen occasionally. And I mean, you know, like, I already said it in my thing.
Oh my god,
you know,
sometimes
the weeks aren't that interesting. And, you know, sometimes I don't have a whole lot to say. I mean, it happens in counseling.
I haven't heard about that in a while.
I mean, I went to counseling for a while. I mean, I can talk about that if you want to. But, you know, I brought Chaz here because, you know, it's like, I like Chaz. Chaz is a good guy. I don't mean to take up all the linguistics of like just like the conversation, but I don't know.
I'll
let Chaz speak for a second.
I'm probably gonna sneeze, so it's probably all right if you keep talking.
Okay. Chaz, give me a big sneeze. Just sneeze right into the mic.
I was going to, but now I've lost it, so it'll come back, I'm sure.
No, sneeze right into the mic, just allow it. Anyways, you know, like, if you know anything about my rambling videos, I don't even know if you watch them. It's not important if you do.
I haven't, I've been really, really busy.
Yeah, I mean, it's fine. I mean, like, that's the whole point of my rambling videos. Like, it's basically counseling in a session. It's just, like, talking about your thoughts, venting them out, and then,
that's what I used to do with my blog, man.
Yeah, you know, I like it like that. I know, exactly. I don't think anyone's watching it, so it's like, you know, be as controversial as you want, say anything, like, unfiltered. It's that kind of ordeal. It's like, essentially, if you go to counseling, it's same rules apply. Just talk about whatever you want, and that's what I do, you know. And so, like, the only thing that's different is, like, I don't know if group counseling is like a thing, but like
it's definitely a thing.
Well, then I guess you could say this is group counseling with Gildem. I was gonna say it's hangout, but I guess it's group counseling. Maybe I'll rename all my hanging out videos to group counseling. No. This is a new segment. It's group counseling. Cause I do that, you know. It's like, I'm no counselor, but at the same time, I like to vent thoughts. And you know what? Vent thoughts, Chaz.
The basement's on fire, man.
Yeah, that happens in the Binding of Isaac. Listen, the point is, this game, not important. The whole point I do with these rambling videos, like, the gameplay, it's just the background. It's, like, the least important thing.
Yeah.
Yeah. So, like, how have you been? What has been up with, Chasisrad?
I got a new job. I don't know if I told you that.
I think I heard something about that. How?
I've been working at it. It's been pretty good actually.
Is it really chill?
Busy. It's busy, man. No, it's not really chill. It's actually really busy, but that's good because most of the all my work has been really chill.
Oh, hey. This, I mean, that's not too bad, right? I mean, like extra work, extra money, right? Got to make that bling bling. You know what I'm saying? Got to make the extra ducats.
It's better experience for me is what it is.
Okay, I mean, like, hey, that's going to pay off in the long run. I mean, because, like, you know how work and experience goes. You get it so you can get a better job. And with a better job, you can pay the bills much more successfully and not have to worry about money in the long run.
That's what I'm hoping for, you know?
Yeah, I mean, like, for instance, with enough time, theoretically, you'll have your yacht, and then you can chill on your yacht with, like, your free Wi-Fi, you know, just chilling there on your
with
yacht.
With free Wi-Fi on
yeah,
my yacht.
Well, I mean, when I say free Wi-Fi, I mean, any of your guests, it's free. Obviously, for you, you gotta pay for it, but, I mean, because you'll be so rich making in those ducats, it'll be free for them. It'll be, like, good, you know, we're talking, like, 4G LG shit, you know what I mean? You know what I mean?
LTE.
Yeah, you know, it's good shit. that's what I'm talking about, you know? It's
4G.
Like
4G, my phone is out. It's going to die. My phone's definitely going to die soon.
Oh, no. But you know what I mean? You're going to pay the bills so successfully that you won't even have to worry about that shit because it's going to be amazing. It's going to be the good shit.
It's gonna be the good like Snoop.
Yeah, except I think that's when he was like Snoop.
That's
Lion.
Snoop Lion, man.
Yeah.
That's Snoop Lion.
So that's not even irrelevant.
That was his like reggae like name.
I like reggae. I'm a weird guy, like I dig any type of music.
Yeah, well, I could go for music. I'm really into what do you call it? I'm into like jazz at the moment.
Are you into jazz step?
Jazz step?
I don't know if that's a genre.
Hey, I would have said.
By the name alone, I would assume it's like some sort of cross between dubstep and jazz.
I mean, there's jazz hop, which is like hip hop influenced jazz.
I guess that technically would qualify, you know.
It's pretty good actually. I listen to a lot of it.
Yeah, well, I mean, like, so yeah, it's just basically I'm just asking how you been.
What? Whoa.
But I mean, like, if you ask me, I mean, I had something happen this week. Not that important, but
what's gone on this week?
So I got invited to an event.
An event?
Yeah. I mean, like, I've talked about how much I'm an introvert, so, you know, it's like, being an introvert such as myself, I don't typically get to the whole socializing event sort of things, you know, because, you know, it just doesn't go when you're an introvert like myself. I don't know if anyone can relate, but, you know, it's like, being an introvert, that's just how I am.
I can understand for you. I mean, I understand how introverts work.
Yeah, you know. Well, I mean, are you an introvert?
No.
Oh, really?
Yes.
You're an extrovert?
I'm kind of like borderline.
Oh. Well, I mean, like, I don't know. I find like
Aside from being an introvert, it
kind of goes between, like, there's a range, like, some days you're more introverted and some days you're more extroverted.
Yes, I can understand that.
I don't know if I want that.
The poop?
It's not poop, it's Guppy's hairball.
That's kind of gross, actually. I would never want to help my cat.
I didn't even want to take that. Well, the reason for it is that, Pining of Isaac-wise, you get 3 of Guppy's items, you turn into Guppy, and it's pretty OP. Not important! Why am I even talking about it? So yeah, I got invited to hang out this week. And I mean, like, that's pretty cool. The problem with it is, I got invited to another hangout. and I'm not much of a socialite. Again, I'm pretty introverted, so it's like this is like one of those nuclear situations. It's like, oh man, I got two hangouts, but they happen on the same day, so it's like, which one do you choose? And it's like one of those crucial events where it's like, how do you even decide? How do you even sort that shit out? You don't know. It doesn't make sense, because it doesn't happen when you're an introvert like myself. Because, you know, I'm a shut-in in my mother's basement. Except I'm not in my mother's basement, because my mother doesn't even have a basement. But if she did, I would be. But my point isn't that, like, where I would be if my mother had a basement. My point is, I got two events. So which one do I pick?
Which one did you pick?
Well, I had to pick my best friend's birthday. See, here's the events. Actually, I shouldn't say my best friend, because I have a lot of best friends, surprisingly. I know, that's so weird. And when I say I'm an introvert, I mean, I'm mostly an introvert. I can't say that I'm a straight introvert, because, I mean, honestly, again, some days I'm more extroverted than I am introverted. It varies. It life works a lot like that.
You died.
Not important, Chaz. Death is fleeting. My point is, this game, not important. It's background. It's not the main focus. The main focus is me talking about my issues, because it's therapy. It's therapeutic. What was I saying? So I got two events. One was I could go paintballing with my friend. It was one of my coworkers. They're much like myself in the sense that, like, they're trying to be more extroverted, and I can relate a lot. You know, I want to be a lot more sociable to any sort of situation.
But it doesn't
always work out, because, you know, being an introvert, you tend to stick to a lot of introverted tendencies. Yeah. I've said this a lot in my rambling videos. It tends to be a prevalent theme. But it's like, the reason why I had to choose my buddy's birthday. Because here's the thing, his birthday's coming up. His wife contacted me.
No, his wife.
Yeah, because it's a surprise party. And normally, I wouldn't think too much about it. I mean, granted, I still should probably go regardless, but... In my last rambling video, I talked about how he's planning on moving across country, so it's kind of like more of an immediate sort of situation where it takes more priority. You know,
he's moving to my neck of the woods.
I would not say that. More like North Carolina.
That's close enough. It's still in my time zone.
It's east coast.
I gotta tell you, man, North Carolina, that's cheap living if you move there.
Yeah, I mean, really, that I think that's the point. And I mean, I'm not gonna talk about a lot of it, because again, I talked about a lot in episode 3 of my rambling video, to give a timeline if I can. But I mean, really, the truth is, it's like, I'm proud of the guy. He's trying to make a living for himself with his wife and three kids, you know, and his family, really. He does a good job. I don't really want to get too sentimental here, because I can't. Point is, you know, I got to hang out with him a lot before he moves, because, you know...
Yeah, oh yeah, absolutely.
I mean, it's one of those things where it's like, I'm never going to see him again. Even though I totally am, because, I mean, come on, it's not like the last time you'll ever see your bro. It's just more or less one of those things where it feels like it. And that sucks, you know what I mean?
Not seeing someone again?
Yeah,
forever?
Well, I mean, it feels like that, you know,
I know the feeling.
It feels like that, it's not, but at the same time, it's just like, all I want to do is chill with my buddy, and it feels like I'm never gonna see him again, but I totally am. The only problem is, if he moves to North Carolina, it's definitely gonna be a far more planned experience where it takes, like, a lot of planning involved. Because, you know, me living in Washington State, I'm gonna have to try to plan all that shit out, where it's like, hey, I gotta get a plane ticket, figure out lodging... Oh. Which I don't even know if I'm going to be able to bunk with my friend. I might. But well, again,
you said he had three kids. Yeah. It's probably gonna be hard.
If he's transfer, because like if he does move over there, it's like transfer from his job. You know what I mean?
Yeah.
So it's like obviously like the first year he's selling in there, it's like that's probably not gonna go down. Second year it's kind of up in the air. Third year probably, I don't know. Not there yet. You know, I'll cross that bridge when it comes. Point is, it's like, if I'm gonna go down to North Carolina to visit my bro, a lot of shit's gotta happen. A lot of planning, a lot of just really irritating details that have to get sorted out. And I mean, they will, especially if I have to go visit my friend, because I will. Yeah. And then I'll go visit Chaz, because it's East Coast, and I don't know, I'll figure out
it's about
light.
It's about a 5-hour drive, depending on where in North Carolina he's moving to.
Riley.
Okay, that's about 5 hours, I think.
Point it, well, I mean, I get a plane ticket, and then I'd, like, go to wherever you are. It doesn't matter.
Probably wouldn't be so direct, unfortunately.
But anyways, you see my point? It's a long planning session of just, I gotta figure all that shit out. And before I figure it out, I gotta hang out with, I gotta go to my best friend's birthday party. Also, my coworker was very, he says he understands, but I kind of feel like deep down, you know, it's like one of those situations where it's like, okay.
You would know.
Like, I felt bad, you know, because it's like, I really wanted to go paintballing with my friend, because like, much like myself, he's trying to be more extroverted about the situation, you know. He's really trying to make an attempt, and it's like, I want to be there for him, you know. It's like, I'm trying to make the move to be a little more outgoing, because being an introvert, much like myself, I don't know, I keep bringing this up in my rambling videos, it's like, I feel like I have to make the honest attempt if I'm gonna, like, be a decent friend. Because, I mean, like, I like being the guy. I like being the guy where, like, people approach me. But, honestly, like, it goes both ways. You can't always be the guy that, like, people have to approach you. Sometimes you have to make the effort to, like, approach people. Because not everyone can, like, just straight up be there to, like, be your friend. You know, sometimes you have to be the outgoing one.
Yeah.
You have to. I wish you didn't, because, you know, I wouldn't. But I have to, you know, and I feel like I'm missing out on a lot of good friendships if I don't. Because I know, at my job, like, a lot of people, they really want to be there. Like, they want to be my friend, but, like, you know, I'm so closed off that, you know, people, they, I don't know, I guess it rubs people the wrong way. Like, they think I'm stuck up or something, you know what I mean? Like, I give the wrong impression.
I hear you.
Yeah, and I mean, like, that's not it at all, you know? It's just I keep to myself. I'm that kind of person. I keep to myself a lot. I wish I was a little more outgoing. Sadly, I am not. But, I don't know. C'est la vie. That's a good expression, right? C'est la vie.
That's life. That's what it means in French.
I mean, that's pretty accurate. But I don't know. So, anyways, I've gutted myself out a little bit. Chaz, do you want to, like, share with the group, the viewers?
Absolutely, sure, my friend. I can understand your concerns about being more outgoing. I suppose it's kind of a interesting idea. You don't really feel that the need to be outgoing, but you're just trying to do it because you want to be. You don't want people to think that you're not friendly, because you are. You're absolutely friendly. I mean, we started talking just because we did.
If I remember correctly, it's because, you know, this guy, Owl Flame, he was like, I have a group of friends, they're pretty cool, and then, like, off the list, like, you and me, we were on it, and
yeah,
we started contacting each other from it. And from there, like, we actually became pretty cool friends.
Went and watched your Mischief Makers videos.
That was my first Let's Play.
Those were great.
Oh,
those were...
That was baby Gildem just trying to get his leg down on how to do things. And you know what? I feel like I've improved significantly from there.
Mischief Makers is a fantastic game.
I love that game. Although it also broke me when I got to the Lunar fight, because I was trying to do something. I think I was trying to get, like, not 100% run, but a huge run.
Yeah, Mischief Makers is cool. That was, like, one of the games we were talking about. Not just Mischief Makers, but Treasure.
Yeah,
In general, we were just talking about their games. They make Gunstar Heroes, too, you know?
Oh, I love that game.
Yeah, that's them. Them and Mischief Makers and Gunstar Heroes is two of their games. It's very good stuff. I want to play this game called Dynamite Heady. Have you heard of it?
I have. I've never played it,
it's a Genesis game.
Huh, interesting.
It's on Steam. I'll have to pick it up next sale.
Yeah, I feel like I need to as well.
It looks pretty cool.
Yeah, I'd be down for that.
I'll have to pick that up next. But yeah, anyway. Mischief Makers, those are good times. Actually, you know what? I don't think I watched Mischief Makers first. I watched your Evo videos first.
Oh, I gotta be honest. That's one of my favorite old school attempts at Let's Playing.
I think that was a good one. That was a really good one.
The reason for it, I think it's pretty informative on a lot of places, just because, like, I really tried to take it like, I really try to cover a lot of bases on, like, game mechanics and stuff like that, and also, like, try to... It has a lot of love of my, my interests. For instance, animals. I love animals.
Yeah.
Like, I'm a huge animal guy. Like, I don't know if a lot of people know that, but it's, like, animals will always take priority whenever it comes to anything, really. Like, even video games. I mean, as weird as that sounds, because, you know, being a Let's Player, obviously, you think... like, video games are where it's at, but no, it's like animals are like my primary love when in anything, really. But I mean, like, video games are like second on the list.
See, and that's my big problem. I don't even know what would be first on my list.
I mean, like, I guess it comes down to passion, you know what I mean?
And that's what I lack, but that's another story. That's a Chaz therapeutic video.
I mean, hey, if you ever want me to guest star on that, just say the word.
That's what I usually used to write about anyway. I haven't written on my blog for a while.
I've been
kind of a chump when it comes to that.
Nah.
But I've been busy.
You have. I mean, like, I haven't really followed to date on everything, but.
Starting,
I mean,
a life on your own is not as... You do a lot. Like, I'm so tired by the end of the day that I just want
to... Yeah, I mean, like, to be honest, I'm surprised on, like, certain days like today, you know. But then again,
today.
Like, we... Like, I tried to plan it really far ahead. Like, just kind of be like, hey, Chaz, like, does this work for you? And you're like, yeah, it works for me. And so it's like...
For a weekend, I did a lot of stuff today. I did a ton of stuff. I did more stuff than I'd probably would want to on a weekend.
I mean, like, even our collab, that was impressive. I'm grateful. I like it. Chaz is, like, a great friend. He reassured the shit out of me, like, during one of our recording sessions. It was great. I hope it really turns out.
I think it will. It was pretty good. Yeah. We had a lot of good, especially during the main run. I kind of started trailing off once you had to redo the gauntlet. But...
Yeah, well, I mean, like, it was all, like, whatever. I don't even know at this point. I guess it doesn't matter.
Well, we'll see it. The finished product will come out.
It should be good. It'll happen soon. I mean, I that's another thing about the whole entire, like, my channel right now. It's like I've been really admirant about trying to get content out right now. So it's like, if everything works out, as I hope it does, a lot, like, I should have a lot of, it should be out relatively soon. It'll probably be more of a once a week sort of thing, but, like, every Saturday.
Right.
Which, I think it's good. I mean, Saturday is a party day, right?
That's, people are out partying sometimes.
And I mean, like, that's kind of what our Mega Man videos have kind of been. It's like, it's a good party video, so to speak.
Yeah. I have not done any videos since the thank you videos. Well, I have a video out. It's unlisted at the moment.
Is it?
Yeah. It wasn't really for... It's not made for public, really.
Oh, that's fine.
I made it for a friend, so he wouldn't suck so much in payday.
Oh, no.
So I made a guide video for him.
I'm not surprised. Chaz, the guide video.
It's not very good. It's a pretty crappy guide. It's got really bad editing, because I don't edit... I don't edit, usually, any videos. Well, if I do, it's just like to take out long pauses or something like that.
Actually,
but most
you know,
of the time, it's one take.
You know, you might be onto something like Chaz's Guide to Payday.
I'm probably the worst person to ask for tips on that game. I'm so unorthodox in that game. That's my problem.
Yeah, that's fine. But well, I mean, like, you've been playing it a while, so I figure, like, you know.
I have, I have 923 hours on that game.
So, needless to say, you know, you enjoy it.
I've been around the block.
And I mean, really, that's all you can say about it, you know? It's like, you've experienced some shit.
I've experienced pretty much anything. Anything that could go wrong, I've seen.
I mean, like, that's fair to say. I mean, I could say the same about Binding of Isaac here.
Man, that looked... I'm watching from the floor now because I decided to get off my chair.
That's fine.
And I just saw the whole screen just turn red.
Yeah, well, I mean, that's happened. Sometimes you get into a room and you're not even sure how to go about it. But yet try. And sometimes it doesn't work out. But, you know, it's like, it is what it is.
This is just a ramble. This is just a chill video.
Yeah, it really is. And honestly, at the end of the day, I'm fine with it. Because, I mean, I'm just talking about life here. It's group therapy.
It's
time to ventilate anyone's thoughts. And, I mean, you're hanging out with me. For the viewers. But my channel's so unknown, so it's
You know what? I think I'll let you see this video.
Okay.
Later.
Imagine...
You won't be able to comprehend.
I'm just
you know
thinking,
what?
Like, imagine this. This is the video that everyone just, like, tunes in. Like, all the off-lookers are
man,
like...
Chaz has an unlisted video. I hope he sends it
to me. Yeah, it's just like, this is a video that really gets me notified. And then it's like, everyone's just like, oh, is this video? Can I see it? And then it's like, if that actually happened, I feel like you'd have to. You know what I mean?
You
like,
don't want to see this video. It's not that good.
But it's like, because there's that air of mystery. It's like, everyone has to see it. Cause it's like they don't know until they see it.
It's a mystery. He made a payday guide. I gotta see that.
Well, I have to say shmoopity boopity.
You know what? Payday. Payday was a gift from you. You bought me payday.
I did, didn't I?
That's one of the greatest gifts I've ever gotten, was that game from you.
The odd thing was, I actually bought it for myself, too, and I was like,
we're gonna play it together,
and then I never got into it.
Our computer's gonna run it, or something like that, correctly?
I don't even remember.
Then I upgraded, and I was like, you know, I'm gonna play it. My brother's like, hey, you have Payday 2, right? I'm like, yeah, I have Payday 2, and he's like, hey, I just got it. You wanna play the game? I'm like, okay, let's do it. I've never played it before. And that's how my life started. I haven't stopped playing it since.
That's how I feel about The Binding of Isaac. Except, I don't know. I think what happened is I saw Owl Flame like play it one day, and I just got really, really interested because I just saw his run. I was like, that looks really interesting. I kind of want to see how I can do at it. So I bought it. So if anyone says like what's really the deal with the Let's Play, there's power behind it. It's like the power of just like if I don't know, like. If you find a game that just looks really interesting, I mean, it can convince you to buy it. So it's like, you know, Let's Players. I feel like
honestly, Let's Players are great. I've bought games because I watched people play it.
Yeah. So I mean, I
watched Dunk play Payday 2. I watched him play it. I already owned it at that point, but I was like, hey, you know what? I think I'll pick up this game just to see. Because he made it look really fun.
Yeah.
I'm going to play it myself.
I mean, like, even reviewers, really. I mean, like, there's a lot of power behind it. I mean, well, the Final Fantasy. You probably don't know anything about this game. That's fine. You will eventually.
I learn a lot about Final Fantasy hanging out with some people.
Yeah. It's probably me. I'm probably one of those guys.
Which one?
It doesn't matter.
Okay. Final Fantasy game.
Yeah, but I mean, I'm talking about like World of Final Fantasy, which is a game for the PS4.
Okay, I don't know.
It came out pretty recently, 2016.
Hmm. That's recent.
Yeah. Anyways, that's not what's important. What's important is when I first heard of the game, I wasn't really interested in it at all. But then I saw like Alpha Omega Sin's review on it, and like it really intrigued me, and so I actually picked it up. And you know what? I love that game. It's a great game. It's amazing. And I was like, I was kicking myself for actually like shunning it. And it wasn't like the chibi art style. It was actually because. Like, when I saw it initially, like, it seemed like it was basically, like, you just travel with, previous heroes from the other series of the Final Fantasies.
Yeah.
And I was like, I don't really think I want to do that. But then it turns out that's not it at all. It's actually Pokemon meets Final Fantasy. And I was like, oh, that's actually a really legit point. Why don't I pick this up? And you know what? It's amazing. I have a lot of fun playing it.
I think videos are like one of the best ways to determine if you want to, if a game's worth your time to play.
Right.
I mean, reading reviews and stuff. Sure, that's good, but seeing something in action is really what's going to like give you your like. I can read about a game. I can read about. Say Super Mario Galaxy, for instance.
Yeah.
I was like, oh, cool, Super Mario Galaxy is the Wii version of Super Mario 64 and all those other games. I really like 64 and Sunshine. I bloody hate Super Mario Galaxy. Freaking hate that game. But I read about it, and a lot of people said, oh, it's great, it's so good. I hate this game. I hate it. I wish I never bought it.
I mean, like, I can kind of relate, because I don't like the control scheme of it, you know?
I hated the freaking control. That's what turned me off.
The whole running on planet. Like, if it was on a controller, if it was on a normal, like, GameCube controller, or even, like, a SNES computer controller, or like an N64 controller, just a controller. If it wasn't on like the Wii like motion controls, I'd probably dig Mario Galaxy. But I could not get used to it. I just absolutely could not adjust to that shit.
Maybe, but what really irked me was the planets. Like, you like run the whole planet. Like you can go.
Oh, okay.
I hate it. That's what I didn't like. Was like, I like. The thing I liked so much about 64 and Sunshine and anything like those games was like, it was flat land. I mean, you could jump on top of buildings and stuff.
Yeah,
but like,
I mean they had kind of a 3D control to them. And
yes, that's they have the 3D world, but this was,
I
like...
I mean, like, it was... I don't know. It had, like... I'm trying to think of the word. I don't know. There was a motion to, like, the planets.
It introduced, like, volume.
I can't think of a better term for that.
Like, I didn't like being able, like, you had to jump on a Goomba that was on the bottom side of a planet. Like, that was kind of, it's awkward.
Yeah, I'd say the jump camera up, the like, camera was a down. Little awkward with Mario Galaxy.
Yeah, I couldn't really get into it.
But again, the control scheme for it was a little awkward for me, just because I had to use the Wii remote, and so, you know, yeah. It's like you're swinging the whole entire controller, as opposed to, like, you know, you're just controlling it like your typical Mario game, you know what I mean?
Yeah.
Like, I like Mario, I like the new Super Mario Bros. On, like, the DS. I had a lot of fun playing that, because, you know, it's like a throwback to the original Mario Brothers, mixed with a little bit of the new stuff from, like, Mario 64 with wall jumping and all that stuff, you know what I mean?
Yeah.
And it's like, I had a lot of fun playing that.
The 2D one?
Yeah.
Yeah, those are great. Those are great. I like, I have, new Super Mario, the Wii one.
Yeah. I mean, like, even, like, the 3D world, which was kind of, like, trying to, like, mix it with, like, I guess more of the Mario 64, style, but, like, with the newer graphics and everything like that.
Like, side-scrolling
3D. Yeah. I think it's Mario 3D Land.
I haven't played that
Yeah,
one.
Mario 3D Land. That's what
That's the one with the cat suits,
yeah,
right?
Yeah. But I mean, like, I dug that kind of shit, because it's like, it's more of the stuff you expect in Mario, you know what I mean?
Yeah.
I say you know what I mean a lot, don't I?
Maybe.
Well, I guess it's just me trying to see if you follow what I'm saying.
I gotcha.
You got the gist.
I gotcha. The guy, this one dude, he was, he's a friend, one of my friends online, he's like, yeah, he's a big Mario fan, he was telling me that I'd probably like Mario Galaxy, and I was like, alright, I'll take your word for it.
You know, the weird thing is, I don't think I'm much of a platformer fanatic as I was when I was a kid, but the truth is, I actually am pretty much really I'm really into platformers, regardless of what I say, because, I mean, like, yeah, I play the Mega Mans, I play the Marios, you know, I have a lot of fun playing them. I try to challenge myself by making myself drunk while playing them.
I don't even know what kind of, like, games I would say I like the most. I mean, if I look at the games I like Euro Truck Simulator, but I also like Payday. And, I mean, those two couldn't be more different.
And, I mean, that's fine. There doesn't have to be a semblance when it comes to video games. Like, zero semblance. Because, I mean, everything's varied. When it comes to, like, genres, I mean, like, I like RPGs. I like horror survival. I like,
Oh, yeah, speaking of horror survival, what do you think about the new Resident Evil game?
Oh, I was wondering if you asked about that. I haven't gone it, just because, like, I haven't gone there yet.
Yeah.
It
doesn't look like Resident Evil at all.
It doesn't. And that, I don't know.
I was really confused.
Brand-wise,
is this really a Resident Evil game?
No, I mean, like, sure. The problem is, it's also misleading in terms of brand. Like, you could name it something else. And like, the hardest part is trying to tie it into the Resident Evil chronology of, like, anything. Like, the Resident Evil lore, in other words.
When I think of Resident Evil, I think of
Chris, I think of Leon, I think of Umbrella, I don't think of, like, first-person Lisa, psychological horror.
Yeah, I don't think
I mean, like, really, if we're going to psychological horror, I think Silent Hill, as opposed to Resident Evil. The only thing that I can think to, like, come up with some sort of semblance of how you could tie the two in is if, like, the character was infected and they're going through some sort of, like, psychological effects of, like, turning into a zombie with the virus before they turn, you know what I mean?
Yeah.
Like, they're dealing with turning while not actually turning. It's one of those really
like
fucked up...
Like all those creepy journal entries that you read.
Yeah, like for Itchy for Tasty.
Yeah.
Yeah, or something along those lines. Not important. Point is, like, Resident Evil 7, it's really misleading. It's kind of like Final Fantasy 12 in a lot of ways because of that regard. And that it's like, why would you name it Resident Evil? Why not just, like, call it something else? And is it because, like, you know, it's not going to sell if you call it something else? Because that's stupid. I think, we need to just, like, we need to forget, like, typical brands and stuff like that. And just start, like, going off with new ideas. Like, just start going on new ideas, you know what I mean? Start, like, rejuvenating everything that we know. Let's get some new horror themes. Let's get some new platformers. Let's get some new main characters that we can grow attached to. Because I would like that.
What was Final Fantasy 12?
Like,
is that the one I played?
I don't know. Probably not.
Is that the one with the Afro dude and the little bird?
No, that's 13.
Okay, I haven't played 12.
13, I could rant forever on 13. I haven't even, like, I lightly touched upon that, I think, in Rambling Episode 2. Because, you know, I could spend forever talking about why I hate 13. Because
that was my first Final Fantasy game, by the
way. That was a shitty one to ever like experience. You picked the worst one.
I did. I picked.
You picked the worst one. Like, if there was anyone to experience, it would not be 13. All right. Like, I would say 7, but that's because I'm a fanboy, and that's because, like, you know, 7's probably not a good one to experience. That's the one to, like, upset Gildem if you have anything wrong to say, because, you know, again, fanboy. So I'm not gonna suggest 7, because, you know, it's like. I could keep going on, like, how perfect 7 is, but I don't want to, because that just sounds lame. I'd say, like, experience 6. 6 is a pretty good one that a lot of people really dig. If not 6, 9's pretty good. 15, actually, you probably like 15.
I want to play 15, but there's no way I'm going to be able to play it anytime
soon. Well, not lately. I mean, like, it hasn't come out for PC yet, but I would say 15. If you're not a fan of, like, the traditional Final Fantasy with the turn-based RPG, definitely 15 would probably be more your bag. 12 actually might also be your bag, just because it's not very traditional in any sense of, like, Final Fantasy. It kind of goes against every norm.
Is that
the
one with
to.
Ha 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 guy?
That's 10.
Yeah, see, I've played that one too.
I don't know.
A little
that,
bit.
That's kind of like the end of, like, more of the traditional sense of Final Fantasy, while also not being traditional in the slightest.
The ones I've played are 1.
Which is really good. I like 1.
13.
13 is the worst.
10.
10. I like 10. Even though, like, the fan base is very diverse on 10.
Wait, 10's Ha Ha Ha, right?
Yeah, 10's Ha Ha Ha.
Okay, I played 10-2 or whatever it's called.
I didn't like 10-2.
The one with the girls.
Yeah, it's like Charlie's Angel meets
Yeah, I played a bit of that one. Yeah. That was alright.
I didn't like it.
Well, I've only played a bit of it. I have the ability to play it. I played the one with the mech lady.
I want to say that's 13, but I don't really know.
No, it's not 13. It's a Super Nintendo one.
That's 6. I know which one you're talking about.
You start in mech.
Yeah, that's 6.
And then she loses her memory.
Yeah,
and then
that's 6.
Guy, and you gotta run away from the woolly mammoths. Except
yeah,
the woolly
that's 6.
Killed me.
That's Final Fantasy.
Played
6.
That one. I played that one a little bit.
That's pretty good once you start really getting into the story of it.
I died to the woolly mammoth, so I got mad and I stopped playing it.
It has a really compelling story. that one.
What else did I play? Two? No? Can't remember. Not two.
Two is a really confusing one.
Not two. I played, the other one on Super Nintendo.
Four, probably. Unless you're a guy in a castle.
You're a guy in a castle.
That's probably four.
You're on
an
airship.
Yeah, that's probably four.
I played that one for like a minute, so I really don't know.
It's probably four. It's a pretty good one. There's a fan base for it.
And then I played the offshoot Final Fantasy, like the one with
Final
Red
Fantasy
Bull.
Mystic.
The crappy Red Bull, the one where I played as Red Bull.
That's not even Final Fantasy. That was like it was a different series. It was just titled under Final Fantasy, and I forget the reason why they decided to market it like that. But it wasn't actually Final Fantasy.
I had a friend who said, he's like, yeah, I don't blame you for not knowing anything.
It's a really confusing Game Boy RPG, and if you don't know what you're doing, like, you will get frustrated playing it.
See, I played that game because I thought it was the other Final Fantasy offshoot game that played on.
There's a lot of spin-offs. That's the one thing you will understand.
One that I really liked. I was like, oh man, this is the best Final Fantasy.
Are you talking about Mystic Quest?
I don't know. I don't know which. I don't know the title.
I think
played it
was
the one time. I played it that one time, and I never could find it again because
I mean,
didn't
it's probably
like...
Mystic Quest. Mystic Quest is pretty easy.
That's probably what it was.
It's basically Final Fantasy for beginners.
Now, is Chrono Trigger considered a Final Fantasy light game, or is that
No?
Okay.
Except for being turn-based.
I should probably continue with Chrono Trigger. I haven't played that.
Yeah. How are you liking Chrono Trigger, by the way?
Well, I haven't played since the last video.
Well, I mean, what'd you think of it so far?
It's not bad. It's not bad at all, actually.
I gotta be honest, when I played Chrono Trigger, I went into it, like, just asking to try to impress me, and you know what, I fell in love with it. It surprised me, it was actually pretty fun.
It was pretty good so far. Yeah. I want my frog back.
I don't want to give any spoilers. If you're gonna keep going, I'm just saying,
he better come back.
I don't want to give any spoilers.
Because I gave him that really expensive weapon.
Yeah, I will say this: Frog is definitely my favorite character. There's no going about that. Frog is my favorite character.
He was rocking that guy.
Yeah, he's just a plain. He's just straight out awesome. In Chrono Cross.
Oh, is he in that game?
No, but a character is named after him.
Okay.
Because he's that badass.
There's a character named Frog after Frog.
No, there's a character not named a Glenn after Frog. Because, I mean, Frog's name is technically Glenn.
Glenn, okay. Yeah.
That's like his actual name.
Okay, see, I just named him Froggy.
Well, I mean, technically, I think that's what, like, his default name is. You had to read between the lines to kind of be like, oh, his name is Glenn. You know what I mean?
Yeah. I gotta do some investigation.
Because, I mean, there's context within the game, and it kind of helps you fall in love with a lot of the characters and stuff going on.
Have you played the other Chrono Trigger game? Something, I can't remember the name.
Radical Dreamers?
That's it.
No, I haven't, but I've heard of it. And it's technically the sequel. Like the immediate sequel after Chrono Trigger. It goes Chrono Trigger, Radical Dreamers, and then Chrono Cross. But the thing is, I'm not really sure how Radical Dreamers fits with the whole entire thing. Because
I've read enough about...
Because, I mean, like, the idea is basically it has two of the main characters from Chrono Cross and I think it's Magus, if I'm pronouncing that right. I might not. Might be Magus.
I don't know who that is.
You will if you keep playing Chrono Trigger. But, I mean...
That's kind of the running joke with these guys that told me to play Chrono Trigger. They're like, hey, how's your Chrono Trigger playthrough going? I'm like, oh, it's going really well, guys. I'm still at the Death Peak. I'm kind of lost in that game. That's kind of why I haven't played it.
That's interesting.
I don't even know what I'm supposed to do.
I see.
It's the problem. Like, there's that car.
Car?
Yeah, there's a car. And I go in there, try to get the car, and then these like robots get mad at me.
You know what? If you want me to make a guest appearance, I probably could help you out there.
I don't know what I'm supposed to do next is the thing. Yeah. I did the sewer thing.
I think I know where you're at.
There was this alligator, he's like, I'm gonna crush you.
Yeah. Anyways, I think I'm gonna end off therapy session here.
Alright.
Yeah. I mean, like, we could keep going on, but I mean, like, I think this is good.
Yeah.
Yeah. So, you know, I don't know. Next time it'll probably be a rambling video when I do one of these things again. But anyways, Chaz, you have been a wonderful guest. Do let me know if you want me to go on to a Chrono Trigger with you. Otherwise, like, I do hope you get back to it.
Yeah, I should.
Yeah. Anyways, otherwise, I don't know. This has just been, you know, group therapy session, hanging with Gildem, essentially. That's why I'm going to title it. Featuring Chaz.
Featuring me.
Yeah. Because, you know, this guy, he's amazing. Anyways, Chaz, do you have any last words?
Yes. Words? I regret nothing.